Okay, so this is now the last topic of the Hour of Kwonmunism. So this Hour of Kwonmunism, being number 6, turned out to be quite longer than an hour. Like I said, I'm not always exact on it being an hour. Sometimes it's a little less, sometimes it's a little over. This week, I certainly had a lot to talk about since I missed a week. I was sick. But as usual, I will end my final topic for an Hour of Kwonmunism is something personal. I just recently turned 26, so I made a video about that, actually, but that's it's weird to be 26. But so, in light of that, I guess I'll talk about kind of the birthdays I've had. That's how I'll end the video, just talking about birthdays. You know, I guess looking back, I can't remember, my memory of my childhood is not so great. I guess I have a long-term memory problem. But going all the way back, the first birthday I can remember is like my 9th one, when I turned 9. I don't know, all my birthdays have usually been really family affairs. I never had one that was like a huge party with friends. There hasn't been that many with where a lot of my friends were involved. All my life, usually my social circle was usually very small. Usually I would have one or two friends, and that would be it, you know, throughout my life. I would move. I moved a lot. You know, I went from Korea to New York to California, and then I moved again inside California, and then I moved again inside California. Then I came to New York, then my parents moved to Tennessee. So within all those movings, I certainly had, you know, a lot of friends who came and went in my life. So usually they were family affairs, usually with my parents and grandparent, the cake thingy was, it's interesting, I don't think we celebrated with cake until my 14th birthday, because it's a Western thing. In Korea, for birthdays, we eat seaweed soup. I know it sounds disgusting, but it's actually really good. But that's the birthday traditional cuisine for birthdays in Korea, seaweed soup with rice. And, you know, before I was vegan, we also would eat that with Korean, like, barbecue beef. So, yeah, usually family affair. I think when I was 13, when I was about to turn 13, I broke my arm. I remember that's probably the most memorable birthday to me. We went to Yosemite National Park, and I had the sling on. And that was actually the biggest birthday gathering for me. Our church went, my dad's church went, and that was when my dad was a pastor of this really big Korean church, and a lot of the church members went to Yosemite National Park together, which is a 5-hour drive or 6-hour drive from where we were living. And we had a great, you know, we just went around Yosemite National Park. There's some pictures of me that I look at. I'm in a sling, and everyone is gathered around, all the church members, and I just look so dead and bored and depressed. But that's because we just came out of driving through Yosemite is crazy because, you know, there's so many twists and curves and there's all these tunnels. So I think I was car sick. So I'm still recovering from car sickness and they're taking this picture. So I'm just like, ugh, kill me now. But yeah, that was interesting. Really big event. We went to Yosemite. My 14th birthday, I hung out with my best friend at the time, and I invited him over to my house, and my mom cooked dinner. She made spaghetti, and we had a birthday cake. Birthday cake was cool, but the spaghetti, in my memory, that was the worst spaghetti I've ever had in my life. My mom cooks Korean food, so this is like, she's cooked spaghetti before, but this is like, she always likes to experiment with her food. And I guess that was the day she decided to really experiment with spaghetti. And by experiment, I mean put a lot of different kinds of stuff in there. And man, some things should not go in spaghetti. She put diced potatoes in the spaghetti. Like that's, among other things. Just that. Just really makes that spaghetti hard to eat. And I remember my friend and I were just eating. And we also thought like, I don't know, my appetite as a kid was huge. I would eat and eat and eat. So I told my friends, like, oh, we should also have pizza. So my friend and I got, like, this box of DiGiorno, put it inside the stove, and baked it. And, like, it came out burnt because I over-timed it. But that's also another birthday I had. 17th birthday was also an interesting one. Because that one actually didn't involve my parents for the first time. Because usually it is a family affair. I came into my first period class in high school. It was my English class, and somebody, like one of my friends, just gave me this bucket. And inside this bucket is like this homemade cake. But it's like, it's a round bucket with like a homemade cake and like cherries on top with like icing and whatnot. Which was really cool. Like, happy birthday, David. And I was like, wow, this is really awesome and it tastes good. But like, it's in this bucket and this is first period. So I'm having to carry this thing from class to class. By fourth period, everyone was laughing because it just ended up being this really disgusting mash of icing, and it looked really disgusting, but it was good. But it was just like, there's a spoon, there's this gigantic cake in this round bucket thing. That was interesting. I think it was my 18th birthday. 18th birthday was my 12th grade. We had this class project, an English class, where we had to make a skit or a play or whatever, and I had a video camera, and we were doing this. So I invited my classmates over for that. I think it was three people or two people. I don't remember, but did I have any guy friends in that? Like, I think it was just most, like, all my classmates that came over, that were in my group, I think were females. So they came over, we did the skit, we celebrated my birthday too, with my parents and whatnot, had cake, ate a lot of stuff. So yeah, those are the fun birthdays. Really, after high school, you know, birthdays don't become as fun. I mean, the time I turned 21, I got really drunk. But that was, you know, after high school, it was usually birthdays were spent without my parents. Or if they were kind of small private affairs. And after that, birthdays are usually now something I do just hanging out with a friend. Like, I would tell very few people know actually when my birthday is. It's not something I disclose to on public, really. I've said this before, but you can go my Facebook profile. That's one of the things that's not disclosed on there. My birthday is not stated on there. Because usually what I do is, you know, there's a friend I want to hang out with, and I'll be like, hey, you know, my birthday's tomorrow, let's hang out, and just kind of do it that way. I don't know, I like birthdays as kind of private affairs. I guess I'm a small social circle guy. My social circles have always been small. I don't know if it started out being that way intentionally, or if that was just how it was handed to me, but now it's intentional. Now that's just how I enjoy my birthdays. And that's, you know, other people invite me for their birthdays. And I don't really like big social gatherings all that much. It's just not my thing. I mean, I'll still go if I'm invited, if I can make it. There's a couple ones when my friends invited me that I wasn't able to go. But I usually just like to hang out with one or two friends that I'm really close with, and just hang out. And that's kind of how it's been. After my 21st birthday, birthdays are kind of like, it's just another day, you know? But I mean, at the same time, I don't want to dismiss it so lightly. It is an important thing that I'm a year older, that I'm still living, kicking, and screaming, I guess, not really. That's the phrase goes. But yeah, I'm still alive, and I'm still doing okay. Life is beautiful in a way. Life is a struggle in a way, but I'm still here. For that, I'm grateful. 1 year older, 26, such a weird number. I feel like when I turn 28, that's gonna be a weird number. And then when I hit 30, that's when I'm gonna feel like, okay, I'm starting to get old. Starting to. I don't know, 30 is still young, but 26, I just can't wrap my mind around that number. And I feel like 27 is just going to pass me by. I'm going to forget about ever being 27. You know, there's a lot of songs like, I remember, like, there's a, Jimmy World did a song on 22, I think, or 23. Taylor Swift did a song on 22. Whoever does a song about 27 or 26, like, that's a number that you just pass by. You don't even really consider. But anyway, yeah, that's been this Hour of Kwonmunism. It's been my sixth one. Next one, I'll try to do next Saturday, as long as I'm not too lazy, too busy, or as long as I don't get sick again. Hopefully, this is the last time I get sick in a long, long, long while. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this edition of Hour of Kwonmunism. All right, catch you guys later. Cheers.